Hello and welcome, Pocket Watch here, and it's about time for yet another episode of Little Busters. Yeah, I don't think we need any long intro, so let's just go to the episode. I believe we are supposed to clean up our club room. Like, I mean, this bad stuff and everything, so yeah. Let us go, and let's clean room this time, because last time we left this as it is, and as no blue text, which we are trying still to keep up. I know I broke it last time, but it was worth it, and it made sense, because, yeah, you know, first time was exactly the same outcome, so, yeah, I wanted to see the second one. And now, obviously, let's clean up the room. Let's see. Well, let's get the room clean. Oh, we are going to clean together with Kuda and Kamikita. Nice.
Okay, da yo.
Okay, da yo.
Yod.
Kyosuke, of course, no.
Hey, watashi souji ya.
Sore yori Riki-kun ni Boguya ya to ka Buhigwa to itta jigoku no otakebi o todorokase tsutsu air guitar demo hiro shite hoshii.
Of course, Kuguragaya, you want. Of course. No, won't happen. Maybe many of the members were unmotivated for the task. Anyway, we need to clean up the room regularly or it will be full of dirt in no time. Yeah! I know you're just saying that because you don't want to clean up. I perfectly get you, Haruka. I perfectly get you by my personal standpoint, but yeah. No blue text. Killing the room won't kill you either. Just suck it up. Okay. It's alright, nobody's gonna be killed. I don't think so. How? Oh my god, are we going to have like some crazy story of Haruka? What is this? Oh, Haruka, what kind of mushrooms are you eating?
Oh
no! That's horrible! Oh no! Okay, that's dangerous actually. I give you a point. Oh my god. I don't know what kind of mushroom she have, but I want some. Okay, I'm not gonna to question it. That was amazing! Oh wow, are we like actually having like... Wow. Okay.
お掃除から地球が滅亡してしまう危険性をはらんでいるわけです。
She's creative as fuck. None of that could happen in the first place.
へえ、あるかもしれないよ。
I mean, the first part could. You could like trip yourself and hit the locker and it could fall down. Absolutely not. You have too many dreams. And also, you are not sleeping. That's a delusion, not a dream. Yeah. She's willing to go that far with her excuses to avoid doing it. At least Komari and Kud is helping us out. Nice, Komari. Kobari-san was shining as she took the initiative in cleaning. Nice, good, nice. I want more interactions with good. Miss Nomi mopping.
Wow, really?
I mean, I don't mind either. Knock off that kind of delusion. Okay. No way. I mean, in the previous road, we already were like dressed up into girl's uniform. I guess he can wear the maid outfit as well for Kurugaya. Oh my god, Kurugaya is. I'm not glad to be told I'm cute. But with that said, it's hard to force Kurugaya-san and Kyosuke to help us clean. It's kinda easy to figure out if we go with Kurugaya, which party will be dominating one. Yeah. Phew. Let's handle it between us then. Komari-san had already stopped mopping. Oh, now you're feeling bad, huh? Oh, so you're going to actually help us. She took them up from Kud. He took them up from Komari-san. Of course they would do that, of course. The workload was instantly divided between us, and we started on our tasks. Such a neat job. Those two just might have overwhelming management skills. Of course, nothing will help Haruka in this case. She stood up. She's a perfect manager. I mean, no, if manager of yours is doing just cheering you up, he's doing bad job, okay? Then she sat back down quickly. Good job. It didn't took like you did anything that hard. Oh wow, that's the motivation we needed, Kurugaya. Kurugaya's amazing character, holy fuck. I love her, I want to see her road. I really want to see her road. Together with Mio. Damn. Yep. She grabbed my mop and started scrubbing the floor. I disagree. To be honest, I'm more way on Haruka's side here. I'm also lazy, I don't like cleaning. I mean, I guess kinda, I don't feel it though. I was like, whatever, it's just clean. Like, nothing changed, really. I don't think that happens, Haruka. She really has a one-track mind. Then I'm getting a bucket for the mobs. Okay, so what do I do? I think we are going to need one more. I glanced at Haruka-san, who was thrusting her mop in the bucket with all her might. The water in this one is going to be messy in no time. That's not even a word! Haruka, what is that? That's Haruka. Also, Kud is so cute, goddammit. Where is it? A space, right? Yeah. Let's just focus on Kud for a second. The favorite doggo.
Yes, I am Moppy!
Wow, the English. Actually, yeah, Haruka was good at English. A cleaner.
そして掃除をしていることはお掃除と言います。Okay。はい、勉強になります。レッツお掃除です。レッツお掃除。
Okay. Okay, we can mix it, I guess. Even though we have various issues, our cleaning was making steady progress. Oh, hello Rin and Mio. Rin and Nishizono-san showed up. Yeah.
お掃除。開口一番に意味不明です。お掃除進行中。クリーニングだ。というわけで、二人ともゾキナーでよろしく。
What's ゾキナー? What? What is that?
雑巾はダストクロスだ。Okay.
ダストクロスでよろしく。ダストクロス?
What the? Haruka, what is that? I feel like Haruka will be main star of this episode. Really, Rin? That sounds kinda stupid. But it stands for one wiping things with a dust glove. We spent about an hour finishing the cleaning. You do? Let's put away the cleaning tools then. As I said that, the door opened. Hey Masato, you're late. Oh, you can like grab boxes and move them around. Yeah, that's up for your muscles. He was crawling into the room like a worm, with both his hands tied behind his back with a rope. What? What are you doing, Masato?
Hiking de tobi hane nagara idou suru training wo omoi tsuite na.
What?
Sara ni onore wo imashimeru tame ni teo fuuin shite koko made kita nda.
He's truly unrivaled when it comes to crazy muscle training. Hey, you are covered in mud. He was moving forth and by jumping like a shrimp. Kengo, are you doing the same thing? Behind him, Kengo entered the room in the same manner. Oh, what the fuck? Ah, not you too, Kengo. Okay. Sorry, but I think I'll pass. Yeah.
Moppa!
Is she cleaning him? Both of them? I love this face on Kengo. It's the first time we see Kengo with this face. Haruka-san began mopping the two guys with astonishing speed.
Okay.
What do you mean? Kengo just accepted it. A few minutes later, both of them were sparkling clean. Well, it's okay, since they turned out so beautifully clean. Okay. Don't you dare cleaning me! Well, at least I'm doing it all the time. Sometimes, I sometimes clean up Kyosuke's room because he never does it that himself at all. Yeah, I'm mostly, almost never cleaning my room as well. I just do it like from time to time. Same with like my hair. It's like way too long now. And I'm just trimming it like once sometime. Same with a beard. It's probably going to be long, not long, and like, you know, in a few weeks or something, I don't know. I wonder whenever Kuroga-san doesn't like cleaning either. It might be tough to keep this room clean, if the two commanders are like that. Again? I suddenly remembered what those two said when we start cleaning. By chance, could Kumari-san have casually pressured them into action? Nah. I think that was an accident. She's not... Nah. The strongest one among us might be her. The natural airhead. Maybe?
Riki, soro-soro meshi ikouze.
Oh yeah. Okay, we are going for dinner. And then something new. On the way there. Hey, Kumari. Oh, I saw Kumari-san standing by the door to the cafeteria for some reason. I mean, we can talk to her. We don't have to, like... Also, she looked, like, worried. Also, this is absolutely new choice. And I really want to take consideration into what I'm actually going to do. I don't think like hurrying to the cafeteria is a good idea, because why would I do that if I see basically my friend being kind of worried and waiting for someone or for something? So I can just talk to her and ask, hey, what are you doing? You're waiting for someone? Like, let's join us on the cafeteria. Something like that, you know? Like, just invite her. Why not? Kumari-san. Okay, so you basically have no bento or something. Or you don't have money for cafeteria. What happened last time? You can let me know in the comments and remind me what happened in this situation last time. Because we definitely didn't have the choice before, so this is entirely new. Who we met before? Did we meet with Kud in the cafeteria? Or it was someone else? Because the blue text before suggesting that we went into cafeteria last time as well, but we didn't meet with Kumari. So yeah, if you remember that, let me know. I see. It's something Kumari-san might do. There's an unspoken understanding about the cafeteria. Girls have their dinner first. Oh, so she just late and they're like all guys and everything is like... you know, no place to sit, basically. It's not a rule or anything, so it's up to each student, but... It might be hard for a girl to enter in atmosphere now. In that atmosphere now. I don't know how it would be weird. I guess that's some sort of like Japanese culture. I don't know why it's hard to enter with that atmosphere. I mean, everyone is just eating their food. It's full packed, but like, why would that be weird? And she's okay with going like in group, okay? I don't know. It's probably some kind of like Japanese mentality. The three of us took our seats. Well, it's a long story.
ちゃんの隣に座るよ。
Sure. Hellbell, Chimt, and Esurin know that. I like that Chim sound. It's really like, I don't know, calming, I would say, even. The dinner today was pork cutlet. Hmm? What's wrong?
Sauce がないな。取ってこよう。
Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah. Kengo left his seat. And then? Masato pilfered a piece of cutlet from Kengo's plate. Oh, you sneaky bastard. Komari-san, who witnessed the theft, put a piece of her own cutlet into Kengo's plate. Oh, she's so kind. She's air-headed and kind. She will tell, like, I'm not eating much. Kengo can have it. Again, Masato snatched a piece of Kengo cutlet and gulped it down. What is going on? Masato, what the fuck? Komari-san made a refill. What is this? I can't. What should I do? I think the most logical sense would be make Masato stop. And I will give you a reason why. First of all, let's talk about watch. That would be like perfect comedy. I mean, not a perfect comedy, but this is kind of funny. Looking like Masato wanting to mess up with Kengo so much that he will eat everything that's on plate. No matter what Kamikita will give him. But on the other hand, Kamikita will lose all her food, basically. And we don't want that. So we can like make Masato stop to like, you know, just keep everything in check and Kamikita will actually have some food to eat. But actually Kengo can come back and see that Kamikita gave her we can take food from Masato plate, right? Am I right? We can take a food from Masato plate then. Maybe we should watch. Or we should make Masato stop. I will make Masato stop. He's like, I don't know. Okay, before I go, let me know in the comment right now which option do you choose. Are you choosing to stop Masato? Or are you choosing to watch the entire thing? Let me know in the comments right now. I will give you a second. And then I will pick my choice. Okay? You done? Okay. So, I think this is pretty funny situation. And we are like in a group of friends. So I think I will just watch. Let's see this. I decided to watch the situation for a while longer. Masato made a voice as he saw Kengo plate. It seems like he didn't notice Komari-san's refilling. Pick up. Refill. Pick up. Refill. In a blink of an eye, the number of her cutlet pieces had halved. Kengo came back with a sauce bottle in hand. Thanks to Komari-san, he didn't realize that Masato had done anything. Kengo handed Kyosuke the bottle. In the meantime, Masato stole away half of Kengo cutlet and jammed it into his mouth. Panicking, Komari-san sent all the rest of her cutlet over into Kengo plate. Since she had trusted her cutlet pieces on the edge of the plate, his dinner looked a little weird now. Okay. She will say nothing. We should stop him, actually. This is That was one situation. But now I'm kinda sad, you know? We actually should stop him. She's just too good. She's too pure-hearted. I didn't, like, put it into consideration well enough, I think. She started nibbling on some sauce-covered shredded cabbage. Masato found Kengo played the field with Kotlet again, and barked in astonishment.
Kyosuke,
oh no, Kamikita have nothing to give you now.
Hiyo.
In the meantime, Masato stole another piece of Kengo Kotlet. Since she had failed to refill the plate, he finally understood what was going on. Really? Okay. In the meantime, Rin moved all of Masato Kotlet onto Kumari's plate. Good job! Everything went well, and it was fun. Yeah. Kumari-san transferred one more piece of her kotlet into Kengo plate. She's too good, she's too good. I would say she's a fool, even. She's way too good. They increased, okay. You ate too much. Anyway. Well, you'll reap what you sow. Oh, she's blushing. Blushing green is cute. She nodded, glancing up bashfully. Seeing her face, Kumari-san beamed radiantly. Those two really are complete friends already. Looking at them, Kyosuke and I smiled as well. I agree. Okay, so now this is like another mission. Okay, what was that? Oh, Kyosuke isn't coming today. Oh, what was he doing? He was like reading manga or something, right? If I remember correctly. There was some reason why he didn't come like today. I think it was like reading manga or something. And we just let him do his thing at that time. By the way, Kengo was here all along. Well, usually yes, but it doesn't seem anything happened tonight. Okay. So, what are we gonna do? Wait, we didn't have that choice before? Why is not in blue? I was sure we had that choice before. And we chose to visit Kyosuke. And then we... Or maybe... No, I think we just... went to the test. I mean rest. Okay, this is kinda... Okay, I might be like not remembering stuff. You can let me know in the comments if you remember this. Anyway, I think we're going to visit Kyosuke because... we can go visit him, check what's going on, and then just say like, yeah, sure, do your thing, like... it's okay. I'm just curious what he's doing, you know? Because he didn't say anything, and he suddenly, without any message, just didn't show up, so I'm kinda curious. So yeah, it's saved. Let's visit Kyosuke. Let's visit him, shall we? He's always coming to us, so now let's go another way. The three of us left the room. Hey, Rin.
Yeah.
Uh, Mr. Mouse is a good Kram's game. Okay. It can go... It got Kengo interest. Yeah, it happened before. Okay, I think the blue text didn't appear in choices because now we have Kengo with his arm. And that's the only reason why it wasn't blue. So this is exactly the same what we chose before because we had Rin text in blue. So the situation happened before. And it's only slightly different. Okay. I mean, I don't mind. But choices like that should be actually in blue, I believe. The door opens. Yeah, it's not Kyosuke. Yeah.
Go
into the room. Okay, so Kengo behavior is like, yeah, he read manga that I remember well. Okay, but Kengo behavior in this road, in this playthrough, is so different since he cannot play with his sword and everything. He's like more chilled, you know, I would say. I think I like this Kengo. I don't know if I like him more than the original one, but I like him. He's so chill. Wow, Kengo. They just desperately trying to get your attention. Something interesting enough. They both look down. Okay, I know what it is. Yeah, is this the one that we had with like mayonnaise or anything? Like this text?
Man! Man!
That's what you say always when you're practicing with your sword. Kengoron was laughing. Yeah. I don't think we were able to find anything. Okay, I don't want to hear that. Yeah, he turned crazy. Let's see. Okay, anyway, this situation is not that relevant for the story. It's just like trying to get Kyosuke to cooperate with us and play with us. I wonder whenever he has any good material. Okay, this is different. That's pretty good impression of Masato. Amazing. Awesome. That genuinely captures his essence. It must be because he's the one who spent the most time with Masato. That's true. I mean, that was funny. Don't worry. Yeah, you did great. The old king could absolutely never have done that. Yep. No, we are calling strategy meeting. Let's step outside. I pushed the three of them into the corridor. Okay. Let's see. I wonder, is there nothing we can do but to give up?
俺があそこまで頑張ったのにか。
お前のそのキャラ何なんだよ。
ほんと怪我してからバカになったな。
え、どうするんだ。いや、
I have a feeling like I want to continue this. It's fun. Let's call the other members. Yeah, I want to mess with Kengo, with Kyosuke a little bit. I don't want to give him time to raid this time. Actually. Yeah, I want to mess up with Kyosuke. Let's call the other members. If we call everyone else, maybe someone will come up with something. Though I'm not sure if I should be involving everyone. Okay. Saying this, he produces his cell phone from his pocket. I don't think Mio can do anything funny. I would like say... probably... Komari or Haruka have the highest chance to make Kyosuke laugh. Kurugaya is too specific. Mio is kinda too silent, I would say. But Komari is so like airheaded, she might do this. And Haruka is just crazy. So yeah, I would say that these two would have like best ideas. Let's see how it will go. That's everybody gathered together. Also yeah, let me know in the comments what you think, which of the little bastards have the highest chance of getting Kyosuke to laugh. I wonder if you will get it right. Yeah, he's not. He's inside. Okay. Imitating Kyosuke's usual course of action, Masato had prepared a banner by himself. And in the usual manner, we spread it out. Okay. What happened with Kengo? Kengo is crazy. Kengo-ron was excited about it. Can the rest of you follow his example? That was a poor performance. Okay. Wait, he did? Wait. No, he didn't. Oh my god. Kurugaya, you're messing up with us again. Ah, she's right. First, wait, what? Wait. It's not true. It's the first. Are they just playing around with him, with her? Without saying anything, she just unhanded Masato an adhesive cooling pad. She gave him a thumbs up.
そんな低たらくでは話にならんな。悪いが抜けさせてもらう。
Really?
あの夏目兄に勝てるとは思えんや。
では、私も。
Yeah. じゃあ私もパース。
Oh, really, Haruka? You going to give up? Well, she don't like to do stuff, so I guess. We instantly lost three of the girls.
私も。
Great. Even the childhood friend were splitting up.The three remaining people shoot him up. Masato, what a wonderful lack of personal magnetism. Komari, I'm counting on you.She asked, looking down at the banner.
Gyafun to 言わせるなら歯車と粉を見せればいいのではないでしょうか? 二つ合わせてギアフーなのです。
No, that's not what it is about.
そうなのですか。
おお、I just needed that waffle. I explained to them what had transpired before their arrival here. Oh, see? I said Komari will be a good choice. Really? Yep.
Domai, Masato.
Gang gang, Karish to him again. Okay, that makes more sense. I have a feeling Komari-san's popularity might be much higher than Masato's. Pretty much. Definitely. Everyone was here again. She explained the situation to them. Okay. He opened the banner again. Wait, what?
Masato da na.
さすがマサトだ。笑わせてくれる。
はいはい、天然ですよ。俺が頭悪うございました。
Okay. I couldn't think of any supportive words for him. Don't mind Masato.
だったらこの私の出番だね。
Yes, Haruka. You are making everyone laugh. You are crazy.
頑張るのです。
Those two guys were really into it.
私はつまらないので。
I mean, you're an interesting person, but not definitely someone who, like, would involve laughing. You're not boring. I wasn't sure what exactly it was that she wanted to say. That's true, actually. This is so true. She's sneaky.
トップバッターは私&ミオちゃんでレッツラゴ
ー。 Actually, yeah, Haruka can like make some kind of very stupid situation joke. Kyosuke will say something and then Mio will be like giving a riposte to that. This is like dream team.
滑ったらツッコミでフォローよろしく。
I didn't thought about that.
いつもみたいにアガイアンチュベシって感じにやってくれれば大丈夫ですよ。
Oh, so it's like make a performance between each other, not against Kyosuke. That's smart. So he will laugh like Mio is actually destroying you, Haruka. No, I'm pretty sure I've never seen Ishizuna-san do that up until now. The never excited Haruka-san and always composed Nishizono-san stepped inside. The ever excited. Let's see. So, mission failed or mission accomplished?
Mr. Kyosuke?
What is that? She cracked up herself before actually doing anything. Kyosuke was concentrating on his mangas before.
この手をちょっと掴んでください。
He stretched out his arm without taking his eyes off the book. As soon as he touched her.
お話。
Okay. Yeah. Exactly my face, Kyosuke. What?No reaction from Kyosuke. Yeah, that was kind of bad. I get your idea, but... Why?
お話と話せっていうお話をかけたギャグで。
Okay, I don't get your idea. I thought about something else. Never mind. She finally began explaining her joke. If you have to explain the joke, then this is a bad joke.
全く面白くありません。
Oh crap, oh wow. Wait, that's the first time we see this face, I think.Whoa, Nishizono! Mio! I don't know if I should be scared or happy or what. How? Wow, this is kinda scary face.
Nani?
Haruka-san was slashed with a harsh riposte. Wow. Nishizono-san had no mercy. Oof. That's pretty low. You could almost see Nishizono-san words float above Haruka-san's head and literally strike her down. She did the thing!As an afterthought, she did as agreed upon. Kyosuke didn't really react to the whole event. That was a good try though. Dragging along the stupid Haruka-san, she returned to the corridor. Yeah, Haruka kinda fucked this up. Yeah, well, that was pretty funny in some ways. True enough, Kyosuke hadn't really even looked up from his manga. He had just finished a volume and was about to start another. Come on, Kumari. You are another person that I believe can do that. Interesting.Kumari-san entered the room.
Hint ってなんだ?
Not sure. Anyway, her learning ability is certifiable. Just maybe she learned something capable enough from Haruka-san's failure to get his attention.He made a half-hearted reply again. About your future? Okay. Eh? Okay, it's the same weird thing. Whoa, she's going to do the same gag. I let you go. Oh, so it's like...I'm firing you or something? I don't get this. I really don't get this. Well, that didn't work. As we thought, Kyosuke showed zero interest. Okay. I don't think we can do that then. The two persons I thought failed. I really don't get that. How could you have confidence in that, Kumari-san? Yeah, okay. She is really an airhead. Oof, even worse than Haruka. You need to choose wisely the things you learn, I thought to myself. Although Rim seems to want to try and cheer her up, she was clearly having a hard time thinking of anything positive to say about the gag. I don't think she... Oh no, that's not happening.
京介さんに勝てるのは姉ご、
夏目兄に乗せられるのもあまり愉快ではない。
She's not good at making people laughShe's good at making people bend to her will. Maybe she will force Kyosuke to laugh. Because if he don't, then maybe something could happen like, I will just burn down your manga, go and laugh. Something like that. Playing along with him.
Kyosuke を乗せようって話だろ?
そうだ、そうだ。
まあいいさ、やってみよう。
She entered the room.
京介氏、ちょっといいか。
なんだ。
お便りが来ている。
Letter for you, okay。
弾丸スキーヤーとしてビッグウェーブにシュプールを残した伝説を持つ京介先輩に質問です。一体どんな道具を使ったんですか。
Wait, what?
まずスキー板は発泡スチロールで作った。浮力があるから。ストックは風呂をかき混ぜる棒で代用だ。そしてアロハにグラサン。麦わら帽子という夏らしいスタイルでビッグウェーブに挑んだのさ。
OK。
まずは暴言から始めた。慣れた頃にはスラロームをこなし、最後には100メートルジャンプまでこなしてみせたぜ。そんな俺を見て、ベテランサーファーのボブがうなったさ。ふーん。夏メイズグレートスキーヤー。ボブさんに夏の申し子です。
わー。
と言った。とな。
OK。She came back to us. Okay. No, you are the only one who's satisfied. But that sure was something incredible we just heard. I guess they both like warf each other. They're both crazy. Oh, you've made a new phrase.It would be cool if it became popular.
しかもあんだけ流暢に語っておきながら、漫画への集中は全く切らしてなかったぜ。
じゃあ、残ったの
は？はい、私なのです。
I mean, Kud is fun to be around with. Right? She's fun to be around with, she's always happy around people and everything, but... She's goofy and everything, but I don't think she has what it takes.To make like forcefully someone to laugh, I would say.
じゃあ帰ろっか。全く期待されてません。
You're not useless, Kud. You are just not cut to the stuff.
だってクドコだしな。
Yeah, I think it'll be difficult for you to for your Kud.
心配には及びません。実は私にはおじい様から伝えられた秘伝の笑っちゃう感じの必殺技が。
Oh no, what is it?
それを使えばどんな人でも報復絶倒起伝将来なのです。
Okay、
意味はよくわからんが、なんかすごそうだ。
すべてはお前に託された。
Is she going to go and talk in English?
クズはかっこいいよ。
She is cool, yep.
はい、かっこよく決めてくるのです。
Coolly. She entered the roomShe snuck around to his back. Doggo, what are you doing? Booyah! She flew at him. Okay? Oh my god, she's trying to like giggle him. Really? She started tickling his armpits. No reaction. Oh.I mean, that was a good try. We never thought about actually trying to tickling him. So that was a good try. She came back to us. Kyosuke's resistant to tickling. Oh, she even... She called her Wanko. Pucci.I want to tickle her now. We never tickled her in the her road, right? I'll to go and just tickle her and see how she laughs. He looked at each of us. Yeah. Oh! Hey, Kyosuke! Kyosuke came out of his room. Huh? What's going on? Wow, Kyosuke, you are a mad genius. Huh? In other words, Kyosuke was leading us by the nose again. Rin had trouble grasping the turn of events. Don't worry, Rin. He spoke calmly. We should go back, yeah? Yeah, I don't think so too, Masato. Even the way he laughed sounded impressive to me. Masato snoring, going far to sleep, yep. Okay, let's see. Okay, about the teams. This is the baseball thing. It's before, like... About opposing team, yeah, okay. So I never can go quickly pick it up.
これが対戦相手。
そうだ。
面白いじゃないか。どんな連中なんだ。
Masato and I also took a look at the notebook. There were details on the opposing team written on it. こいつらは野球部じゃねえじゃんか。Yeah, this is about the whole team of like other club, like captains and stuff. It was later about a member of track club on the first spread. Next two pages were about the soccer club. Additionally, they were like captains of their respective clubs. What does it mean? Could be that team consists of all captains from all sports clubs in the school? Yeah, it is. And also, I think this is a good place to end the episode because this sentence is perfectly showing about what we can expect from the episode. So it will be easier for me to like begin in the next one. So yeah. That was a pretty fun episode. I really like that. I like that little fight with Kyosuke and how at the end he actually does by the nose. That was great. We had a good tries. I really like that. Let me know what you think. And yeah, I will see you in the next episode. So thank you for watching. Thank you for being with me. And for now, Pocket Watch is going out.